Hey guys, it's Thomas here with Technovision, and welcome to the next part of our modding tutorial series. In this episode, we're going to be talking about loot tables, which will allow you to create custom drops for the block you just made. So we can just get right into it. What you need to do is come over to your source directory here, go to resources, open that up, and you can see here that we have our assets folder, and we don't want to mess with this. We want to actually make a new directory. So you want to right click on your resources folder, right click, new directory, and you want to name this data, D-A-T-A, enter, and you can right click on data, new directory, and you want to name this your mod ID. So again, in my case, it's tutorial, but you can put whatever your mod ID is, hit enter, and that should be a subclass of data. And inside of this mod ID folder, we want to right click, new directory again, and this file or directory is going to be called loot_tables. Hit enter, and this is going to store pretty much all of your loot tables, although we need some more subdirectories to specify what type of loot table it is. So we're going to be making them for blocks in this video, so we want to right click, new directory, and we want to name this blocks. Hit enter, and so now we have our full directory here. So it should be resources, data, tutorial, loot tables, blocks, and inside of this blocks folder here, we want to right click, new file. And this file is going to be just like all the JSONs you made for your block, just the name of your block, this name that we set here. So in my case, I want to make a loot table for my Ruby block so that we can make it drop, a Ruby block when we mine it. So again, I'm just going to name it what I set it here, Ruby_block. And instead of, and it's actually going to be .json as well. And we can hit add to the repository. Alright, so what you want to do is go to the description of this video, and there should be a bunch of links to different pastebins, and the first one you're going to want to click on should be the first one in there. We'll take you to this basic loot table pastebin here, and you're going to copy this, but I just want to mention that loot tables can be really complicated, especially if you don't understand a JSON syntax, or you know, you're just not very used to coding in general. So I try to make this as modular as possible, so you can think of it kind of like a Lego block, and we're adding more Lego blocks onto it. So we'll be getting into add-ons in a second, but for right now this is just a basic JSON. So you want to copy this first pastebin in the description. Again, it's called basic loot table, I believe. Go back to your IntelliJ and you can just paste it into your JSON, and this is a basic loot table essentially. So let's just go through this. So first we want to actually replace our mod ID with tutorial, or whatever the name of your mod ID is. And then the item name, this is gonna be what drops when you mine your block. The block this is affecting is of course the block, the name we set for our JSON, but this is what actually drops. So if you want it to be one of your custom items, like I want my Ruby block to drop just another Ruby block when it's mined. So I'm gonna do tutorial, colon, and then again, this name right here that we set, Ruby_block, just copy that real quick and paste it in. So what this is saying is this is a block loot table, so it's affecting a block, and it's happening one time. This is essentially this number, it's called rolls, determines how many times this loot table occurs when you mine a block. And then we have basically just one entry in here, and that is that it's dropping an item, and this is the item right here, this is the name. Now, again, what this is going to do when you mine your Ruby block, it's going to drop one Ruby block. But if we wanted it to drop a vanilla item, for example, let me just copy this so I can save it. What you would do is type Minecraft colon and then a name of a Minecraft item. So for example, apple. What this would do now is if we mine our Ruby block, it'll drop one apple, but I don't want this. I want my, I want it to drop the block itself. So I'm going to go back to my mod ID and then our custom block here. And again, this right here, just for this custom setup, you can actually modify this to determine the count. So if right now it's at one, so it's going to drop one Ruby block. If you wanted to drop, let's say, three Ruby blocks when you mine a single block, you could change this to three. And this probably isn't the best way to do it, I'll be honest, but it will work. So you can modify this value just with this basic loot table. You won't be able to do it when we get to more advanced loot tables, but with this one, this will be the amount that it drops. So I'm going to keep it at one, and I'm going to file, save all, and I'm going to come up to the green triangle to run the game, and I will see you guys in the game. All right, so we're inside of the game here, and I have some of our Ruby blocks laid out here, and if we mine it with the diamond pickaxe, we can see that there we go. We do have a block drop. It's just a basic block drop of the item itself or the block itself. And you can see that it works every time we mine the block. Now, remember from the previous video when we set the harvest level or the harvest tier to iron only. So you need at least an iron pickaxe to harvest this block. So let's just show that real quickly. If we were to use a stone pickaxe, you can see that not only is it taking a lot longer, but we actually won't get the block back. And we can see that right now. There we go. And that's because it does not meet the harvest level. Okay, so now that we have a basic loot table working, we can get into more advanced loot tables. Now, I can't show you every single possible type of loot table because technically there are an infinite amount of types because you can customize them however you'd like, but hopefully by the end of this video, you'll get a feel of what you can kind of do with loot tables. So in the description, go to the second link and that will take you to this paste bin here called multi-drop loot table. And you can copy this, I did not mean to save it. Right click, copy. And we can just delete this loot table because we're gonna replace it with this new one. Right click, paste. Now what this new loot table will do, and again, you don't have to use this if you don't want to, but these are just, you know, different types for you to use. This will allow you to set a minimum and maximum drop amount and then randomize it. So let's first set our mod ID to tutorial. And I actually want it this time to drop our ruby. So I'm just gonna type ruby. Again, this doesn't matter. It's whatever you'd like it to be. This is what drops. What does matter in this case is these two values right here. So again, you don't really need to concern yourself with all of this stuff right here or this type. Basically, this is the minimum amount that could drop and this is the maximum that could drop. So if I set this to 4, for example, what this means is when we mine our ruby block, let's open this up real quick just so we can see it. When we mine our ruby block, it's going to randomize a number between 1 and 4 and drop that amount of rubies. So let's hop in the game and see that real quick. Okay, so we're in the game now and let's test this out with a diamond pickaxe. So if we mine our ruby block, you can see it did drop multiple rubies here. And we got 4, so we got the maximum amount. And we can keep trying this actually. Let's just throw these away so we know exactly how much we're getting. This next time we mine it, we got 3 rubies. Let's try one more time maybe. And this time we got 3 again. So you can see here that it's randomizing the amount of rubies that we get between 1 and 4, and you can change that number however you'd like. All right, so now we can start talking about add-ons. So if you go to the third link in the description, it'll take you to this paste bin called Fortune Add-on. And what this add-on will do is allow you to set a multiplier bonus for pickaxes that have a fortune enchantment on them. And this is actually how a lot of ores work. So if you copy this code, right click, copy. And again, this is all optional. Again, the way I'm explaining this is it's kind of like Lego blocks. So for example, this functions block here. Inside of here, you can think of this whole space in between these two brackets as like one Lego block, and we're gonna keep pasting new Lego blocks as we add more details to our loot table. So in this case, we want our fortune enchantment to affect our drop chance. So it's gonna go in our functions area here with our drops. So right below this drop block is what I'm gonna call it. You can right click, paste it in, and I'll just move it up a bit. And again, what this is saying is it's applying a bonus, and it's the enchantment that is applying that bonus is the fortune enchantment. And this is the multiplier here. So the higher you set this number, the more fortune enchantment is gonna affect how many emerald or rubies in this case you're gonna get. So if I set this to like 3, for example, instead of getting between 1 to 4 rubies, I could get anywhere, you know, I could be getting 9 rubies potentially if I had a fortune enchantment. But I'm gonna set this to 1, and I'm actually gonna lower our min and max just so we can see this in action a little bit better between 1 and 2. So let's hop in the game and check this out. Okay, so inside of the game, we can test this out now, and let's try with a regular pickaxe, and we should get anywhere between 1 to 2 rubies like we said. And there we go, we got 2 rubies. Let's try that one more time. That time it looks like we got 1 ruby. So perfect, it's working great. Now let's try the fortune. So we have a fortune diamond pickaxe here. And I'm gonna throw away these rubies just so we can see exactly how much we get. And let's place down a block and mine it. Now with the fortune enchantment, it looks like we got 2 rubies, but that might just be by random. So let's try again. And this time we got 3 rubies. So you can see that we did get more than the maximum amount that we set. And that's because we set that fortune enchantment. All right, so the last add-on that I'm gonna show you guys is the Silk Touch add-on. And this is gonna let you actually create a fully functional ore. So let's go to the last link in the description. And that's gonna take you to the final pastebin, which is this Silk Touch add-on. And you can copy this code, right click, copy. And in IntelliJ, we wanna paste this inside of our children area. I know that we added these blocks here within functions, but that's because they were specific to this drop rate, the set count that we were making. This is actually gonna drop an entirely new block. So it's gonna go inside of children above what we've already made. And we can right click, paste this in and move the rest of the blocks up. And what I want this to do is the functionality I'm thinking of is that we have this ruby block, and if we mine it with a regular pickaxe, we just get a couple of rubies back. And if, you know, if we have fortune, we get a couple more rubies, but if we mine it with a Silk Touch pickaxe, then we'll just get the ruby block back. So, we're actually going to make this mod ID our own. So tutorial, and the item name is going to be ruby_block. Cause again, this is the line. This is what drops, from this block of code here. And what this is saying more or less is if the tool is correct that you're using, then if an enchantment happens to be on your pickaxe called Silk Touch and its level is at least level 1 Silk Touch, then it will drop this block. And if none of this is true, then it will move on to the next category of blocks, or the next blocks in general. So that's sort of how these things work. They're just blocks that move on from one to the other, and they're based on conditional statements. And again, this levels here, this sets the minimum level. So if I were to set this to 2, then it would require Silk Touch 2, which I don't think actually even exists in the game, but you can use this same sort of idea down here for fortune. If you wanted it to, you know, if you wanted your block to require fortune 2 or 3 or something in order to actually get the effect. But we're gonna set this to 1 and check it out in game. Okay, so first we want to try out a regular diamond pickaxe on this block, and there we go. We get the regular drop that we set, which is 1 to 2 rubies. And again, we can try that one more time just to make sure. You can see this time we got 1 ruby more or less. Now let's try it with a Silk Touch pickaxe. So I have a Silk Touch diamond pickaxe here, and if we mine this, there we go. We just got the regular block, and let's try this one more time just to make sure. There you go. So you can see that it's working. And again, this is pretty much the exact functionality that a redstone ore block, or you know, any sort of ore block has, where if you mine it with a Silk Touch, you get the actual ore block. But if you mine it with a regular pickaxe, then you get the actual ore or the gem or whatever. All right, so one last thing I want to mention before we wrap up this tutorial is that there is actually a really easy way to just copy Minecraft source code if you're stuck on this. So if you go to your desktop here, there's my recording software. If we go to our file explorer and we go to %appdata%, we can go to our .minecraft folder, go to versions, find 1.15.2, and you want to right click on this executable jar file here, right click, open with WinRAR. And we can see very similar folders to what we have in our IntelliJ. If you go to data, Minecrafts, and loot tables and blocks, you can see the loot table for pretty much every block in vanilla. And I mean literally every single block. So if, for example, you wanted to search for redstone ore, you could just drag this out to your desktop and go over to it. And if you right click on this this JSON with open it with something like Notepad, you can actually see the full loot table for this block. So, you know, if you wanted to make something that was very similar to like redstone ore, you could literally just copy this source code and just replace Minecraft redstone with, you know, tutorial and the name of your custom item or block or whatever you want to make, ruby block. Yeah, so I just wanted to show you guys that because it is a lot easier to sort of find these functions that way other than just asking around. All right, well, that is gonna do it for this episode. Thanks guys so much for watching. I hope you guys learned a lot, and I will see you all in the next episode.